There's wind blowing like snow all over the place, so fingers crossed that that's not gonna be a big problem.
Hey, I'm Kristen. I've been traveling mostly alone for the past 8 years. I've been to over 50 countries, and a couple years ago, I met this awesome human named G. After an amazing trip exploring Alaska in the winter, Garrett and I decided to treat ourselves to one last amazing thing before we left. And that is where we found the Aurora Yurt.
Hello once again from Fairbanks. So we are getting ready to head to our beautiful mountain yurt, but we need to get some provisions first. So we're at Fred Meyer, which is like a huge store, like a Walmart. If you saw the last video, we're coming from Denali National Park, which was beautiful in the winter. I'm sure it's so packed in the summer, but there was basically nobody there when we went, so that was amazing and awesome. We did see some aurora. Really hoping to see it tonight. We've got clear skies, at least for now, so fingers crossed, toes crossed, everything crossed for that.
Never seen this before.
Ooh, the chip aisle.
Garrett considers chips like a major food group, right?
Yeah.
Ooh, I love popcorn.
Yes, I love popcorn.
Yep.
Okay, so $78 all in for all the food we got for 2 full days, I think is pretty reasonable, especially considering that probably most things have to be brought here. And most places you go to see the aurora, because we are here to see the aurora, you pay a lot for groceries, like Iceland, Norway, Finland, you'd pay a lot for food, you pay a lot for everything. So I think that Alaska is actually a pretty good deal, especially if you're coming from the States already.
Okay, here we go, time to go up the mountain to our yurt.
Are you excited?
Yes. Let's do it.
It's driving up, it already looks magical.
Look at all the Whoville trees.
Already packing, come with me. I'm not really asking. We'll get away to a place where we don't know.
Wow.
We'll get away. This is what we waited for.
Damn. I'm excited too. Look at that. Look at that.
Ready?
Alright, so now we're inside the yurt, and it's already a lot bigger than I thought, which is really cool. And first thing that you notice when you walk in is this really big kitchen over here. We have this island here where we can sit, but there's also a table behind Garrett there. So you got multiple options for where you're gonna eat. Full stove, nice big sinks, full fridge, which is nice because we brought everything we're gonna eat. We're on a mountain now, so it's not like there's a ton of restaurants nearby, so it's perfect that we have this kitchen that we can cook in. Initially, I thought that it was just this one room in the yurt, like you think yurt and you don't think it's gonna be this big place, but it turns out there's like multiple bedrooms. Bedroom, this bed. Oh, this bed's pretty good. I have to give it the full test though. That's really nice. This is like super fluffy.
So fluffy, I'm gonna die.
It's so fluffy.
I think this is probably gonna be where we sleep. So this is the bathroom, and we've come to notice that it's really common in Fairbanks for places to not have bathrooms, like to have an outhouse that's outside. So to have one, and especially with a washer and dryer, is actually rare. And when you're looking for places to stay, at least when it's winter time, I don't really think that going outside to use the bathroom would be all that pleasant.
Don't want to have to drop a deuce out there.
Looking up to see the northern lights, which I I think we'll be doing later for sure. And this is our home for the next 2 days.
You might be wondering how I found such a unique stay. Well, first of all, I knew that I wanted to stay outside of the main area of Fairbanks so that we could have clear skies. So I went on Airbnb and I checked the all-important hot tub box. That certainly narrowed down our options, and that's when I found the yurt. It just looked so magical, secluded on Moose Mountain, far away from city lights or really anyone or anything else. It was a little bit more expensive than we usually spend for a night in a yurt at $300 with Airbnb's fees and the taxes, but it was worth it for us to have that unique experience for our last 2 nights in Alaska.
So one of the big questions of this trip is, are we going to see more aurora? If you watched our last video, we did see it in Denali National Park. Got super lucky. It was supposed to be cloudy, but the skies ended up clearing, and I think it was a KP4. It was dazzling, but tonight looks really, really good. Cloud cover has been a major issue so far, but this looks pretty good. It's supposed to stay clear. We've got a few more hours of sunlight, and then we're gonna know, are we gonna see some aurora tonight or not? In the aurora yurt. Dun dun dun. Sun is down and it's dinner time in the yurt. Okay, so there's a webcam at the top of a mountain here that kind of shows us what the aurora looks like, and it's super low on the horizon now, but there's another website that shows where the aurora oval is, and it's not quite over Alaska yet, so
we wait.
Midnight. Panda face. We're gonna go try our luck.
There are plenty of other things to do around the yurt, like snowshoeing and exploring, but there was one thing in particular that we still had to do.
I'm scared. Do it! All right! My bare skin's not happy, but I'm alive.
So hard to be steady. Oh, look at them. Hi, guys. Hello. He's like, hey. Hey, me too.
Both get pets. Because my skin's so hot.
No.
Yet.
I feel good.
After an amazing stay in Alaska with so many wonderful wintry things to do, there was one last somewhat unconventional thing I just had to try.
Okay. Garrett's sleeping, which is perfectly reasonable. We haven't slept much this trip. But there's something I gotta try while the sun is out, all beautiful like this. One of the first days we were here, I bought this at Fred Meyer.
What are you looking for?
I want bubbles. I saw something on TikTok I want to try. Ooh, Blue's Clues? Or Peppa Pig? Which one?
I like the blues.
Yeah, I do too.
So let's see if this actually works. Well, they're not freezing like I had so hoped, but they are pretty.
That wraps up a magical stay in the Aurora Yurt, but have you seen our other videos of Alaska? Check out Denali National Park as well as our crazy road trip through the tundra. See you next week.